Welcome back to Design Bundles YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to sublimate a waffle weave towel. This is a question we've had multiple times, and it's also something that's pretty trendy in the sublimation world. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Starting off over here on designbundles.net, this is the file that I'm using today, and as you can see, it is a super cute buttermilk biscuit recipe. Now you could do this, as you see here, on a sign. You could do this on a tea towel, whether you're using just HTV, or you can sublimate it with, it's a polyester towel. Now this waffle weave towel here is a 100% polyester, so we're going to be sublimating, but once again, you could use adhesive vinyl on a sign. You could use HTV and put that on a tea towel if you wanted to. So lots of different things that you could do with this file. Now you could also bring this into your Glowforge and put this on a cutting board. So lots of different things, like I said, and it's only one plus credit. So if you guys are a plus member, you can get this right now for only one plus credit. We have it linked down below so you guys can check it out. All right, so let's go ahead and drop our screen down here. I'm going to go ahead and switch my cameras here. And so I can walk you guys through all of the supplies that I'm using today. So as you guys seen, this is the file. This is what it's going to look like. I just printed this out on an 8.5 by 11. And I believe that I did my size right here. It's either 7 or 8 inches. 7 inches wide is what I did. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold it to where it's a little bit of a bigger design. Now you could bring this in smaller if you wanted to. But like I said, I did mine 7 inches wide, which gave me, I'm going to give you guys those dimensions really quick. It gave me around 7. So it's about like a 7 by 7 is what it is. So I've got my design here. I've got this waffle weave towel. We've linked down below the ones that I'm using today. These are 100% cotton. They're super nice, but as you can see, it's got that waffle weave to it. And like I said, we've been getting a lot of questions on it. So I thought it would be a good one to do today. Now, if you guys are just now joining us, tell us where you guys are from. What are you crafting today? How is the weather? I want to know all of the information. I also want to know if you guys have tried out any of the new presses, whether it's the Hat Press or any of the new Cricut Easy Press. For example, the Cricut Easy Press 3. I want to know your thoughts down below. All right, so here we go. The very first thing that we want to do is set our settings. So I've got the waffle weave towel. We've got the lint roller here. And then I've got my tape dispenser as well as my tape. All of the supplies that I'm using today are linked down below. And then I've also got a piece of parchment paper here. Now, you guys notice that I always use this brown parchment paper, but I have recently found it in white, and that's what I have linked. I've linked them both down below, let you choose. But I'm going to start using the white one because I'll be able to use it with our HTV and adhesive vinyl projects as well with layering stuff. So you can definitely purchase same amount, same. You get 200 sheets and all of that from Amazon. So I have that as well. All right, so step one, let's go ahead and get this laid out flat. So just figure out what side you want to do it in. I have the tag on this side, so I'm going to go ahead and flip mine around and do it on this side here. All right, we're going to lay it out here. I've got my Cricut pad here, and then we are going to go ahead and lint roll. So you never want to avoid this step or forget this step because this can cause some little blue dots. You definitely want to remove any sort of lint or debris. Okay. So now let's go ahead and set our settings. I've got the heat app that goes to the Cricut Easy Press 3 already downloaded on my phone. So I'm going to click on the one that I'm using today, and then I'm going to click start new project. Now, because sublimation is the exact same thing as Cricut Infusible Ink, that's what I'm going to choose. So we're going to go ahead and check our transfer materials, and we're going to choose Cricut Infusible Ink transfer sheets. So then I'm going to go over here and I'm going to tell it that I'm using a baby bodysuit because they're 100% polyester. And then we're using the Cricut Easy Press mat. We're going to hit continue. So it's going to do 385 for 40 seconds, which is good enough. Now you could go in and do custom settings if you wanted to. We're going to hit send over. So now you can see that there. And so it's going to go ahead and send them straight over here. Now you notice it says 15 seconds because our very first thing we need to do is pull out any sort of moisture and pre-press. That's what we're going to do now. And so I'm going to go ahead and hit the go button, and that's going to go for 15 seconds. Now I want to do this twice because this is a big design. So once this is done, it's going to try to revert over to that 40 seconds, but I'm going to show you guys how to go backwards to get it back to the 15 seconds in case you guys are new to using this. So you see how it went to 40 seconds. I'm going to move this up so we can get the top half. We're just simply going to hit the back button and it should take us right back to 15 seconds. We're going to hit go. So that way I can give it another 15 seconds on the top part of the towel. So we want to make sure we're doing the entire thing because, like I said, we're going to get it into presses. If you guys are just now joining us, we are sublimating a waffle weave towel using the Cricut Easy Press 3. All right, so here's our design, and we're also using this super duper cute design that is only 1+ credit. So now what we want to do is flip this guy over, get it where we want on our towel here. I'm thinking somewhere right about in here looks good to me. And then we're going to take two pieces of tape. So I've got one here, and then we'll get one more right here. Once again, all the supplies I'm using today are linked down below. All right, so now I'm going to cover the top with the parchment paper, and I'm going to kind of look at it because see where that line is? I want to press top half and then the bottom half. So we're going to do that now. So I'm going to go ahead and get the top half just like so. We're going to hit go, and this is going to give me 40 seconds. Once again, I'm going to press this twice because it's a little bit of a longer design here. And I possibly could have fit it underneath this entire thing, but we're going to go ahead and do it twice just so I can show you guys. So we've got about 23 more seconds. And like I said, let me know down below, have you guys tried out sublimation? If you do, what do you think about it? What printer do you own? I want to know all of the things. All right, so we've got about 10 more seconds here. All right, almost there. And then we're going to switch it up. All right, here we go. So let's go ahead and carefully move it down. So I'm gonna go ahead and come down here. We're gonna go ahead and hit go again. Because I hit go, it's still on that 40 seconds. And then I'm just going to go ahead and give it some pressure down here. You can already see that design coming through where it's sublimated. So you just want to give it nice, even pressure. So we've got about 25 more seconds here. We're almost done. I love these towels. I really like them too because they're almost like a microfiber. So they're going to be really nice to clean down some surfaces. Some also really cool things that you could do is you could do a golf towel for dad. Father's Day is coming up, so you could do a golf towel for his golf bag. That would be a really good one. You could do some summer themed ones, lots of different ideas. All right, so we're going to get that guy out of the way. And I'm going to double check here that I got this little piece here before I completely take it up. And I think I did. I've got it all. So here we go. How cool is this? I love it because it looks like it's handwritten. And, you know, it looks like grandma gave me this recipe years ago and I've put it on the towel. So I absolutely love it. For somebody that doesn't have any handwritten recipes, but you really want to create something like this, we have the files for you. I think once again, this would be great for Mother's Day, even Father's Day gift. And so what I'm going to do is I would fold it like this. Get our first fold there. It over. And like I said, I really like the, whenever you go to boutiques, you may notice that they do the more chunkier fold like this. And it would look just like that. How stinking cute. Let me finish folding this. Let me fix it for us here so we can see. You guys let me know in the comments below, what do you guys think of this towel? Is this not absolutely gorgeous? I love it. I think it came out so cute. And it's a ton of fun. It really would make the absolute perfect gift or the perfect decor piece for your kitchen. So really, really love it. Another thing is this would be great for a kid that just got, maybe somebody that got married, housewarming gift, somebody that's went off to college and things like that. I just think all the way around, it would make the absolute perfect gift. And this is with that waffle weave. So how cool is that? So easy. And I was able to use that Cricut Easy Press 3 to make this happen. So really, really cool. Tons and tons of fun. Love it. So I'm going to go ahead and bring the camera back up here and I'll kind of show you guys that size there. Now, once again, you can feel free to fold the towel however you would like. So say, for example, we have tons more designs. You could do a family monogram on here. So you could actually right over here in this bottom corner here, you guys could add like a family monogram and things like that, but you could even do like a Mr. and Miss and do some bathroom towels, lots and lots of ideas. But like I said, does this not look like Grandma Rhoda herself? I think it's so, so cool. And it would be the absolute perfect gift. So super excited. Like I said, you guys let me know in the comments below, what do you guys think about this? Do you guys think that you would try to make this project? And then also, like I said, have you guys tried out the new Cricut Easy Press 3? I'd love to know you guys' thoughts on this. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with us here today. And if you guys enjoyed this, please hit the thumbs up. Also, if you guys have not already, make sure you guys go check out our Facebook community group. We have hundreds of thousands of crafters over there, lots of inspiration, as well as giveaways. You're going to see freebies over there, tons and tons of stuff going on, but you're going to get answers. If you need help, somebody from the crafting community or somebody like us, one of the members of Design Bundles is there to help very quickly. So you can find that down in the description as well, or even in the comments. I'm sure Brittany's putting that down there for you guys. But like I said, if you guys have enjoyed this, please hit the thumbs up and subscribe. And we'll see you guys on the next one. Bye for now.